Love is the essence of who you are. You are nothing more or less than love. As you perceive yourself in this physical reality, as an individual, you might intellectually understand that you are love, but you can't really be aware of what that is, because in amongst your vibration is your set of beliefs, beliefs that you've attracted along the way, beliefs that you brought in with you, intentions you set prior to your birth. And so that is a mix of limiting beliefs and empowering beliefs. And as you are able to alter your set of beliefs from limiting to more empowering, you gain more clarity. And in that clarity, you can see the potential of love that exists in all things. So the physical reality is just the manifestation of love. But for it to actually manifest and for it to mean anything and for you to be able to see it, you must also have the presence of fear. And so as the presence of fear exists in physical reality, you might need to protect yourself, to worry about failure or loss or rejection or even death. Or boiling it all down to the fear of the unknown. If you knew how it was all going to work out, if you knew how everything did work, if you knew that you were essentially love, well, then you would not act on any urges to change the conditions, never need to control anything, never have any doubts about who you truly are, never have any true interactions with other people. You would exist in physical reality as you exist in the non-physical, and therefore you wouldn't really gain much. You wouldn't really go through very many experiences, and you wouldn't have the opportunity to consciously adjust your set of beliefs. In fact, you would have no limiting beliefs without the presence of fear. And without the presence of fear, you couldn't really go on a journey of self-discovery because you would know who you are. Well, in this physical platform, in the mechanism of physical reality, you have the limiting beliefs that you brought with you, limiting beliefs you adopted along the way, and this confusion about who you truly are. As you live life after life after life, you have all these experiences and you gain from those experiences through expansion. And when you return to the non-physical, you understand the expansive experiences and you see love from a new perspective that was unable or you could not see it that way before. So the experiences add to your expansion, and those experiences based in fear are as expansive as those based in love. Now you've come to a different time in your reality. You've come to a new level of awareness. This is the time of awakening. And you have the opportunity to look at yourself from a higher perspective and understand the basis of who you are and every molecule, every life form, every manifestation is a manifestation of love. But from the limited perspective, it's not always easy to see that. You can't see how getting into an argument with a spouse is a manifestation of love. You can't see how raising a child and dealing with all the manifestation events of the child is the expression of love coming forth. You might say, if my child was happy, then I could feel good, and that is love. If my child is going through some manifestation event or some obstacle, I wish that wouldn't happen because I can't feel the love that I'm wanting to feel. And we say, as you move forward through all these experiences, through another level of expansion, you will have greater feelings of love, greater feelings of joy, greater feelings of satisfaction, greater feelings of alignment, and greater clarity. This is what you truly want. Because without the confusion, you could not come to clarity. Without the fear, you could not come to love. Without going through these manifestation events, you couldn't identify your limiting beliefs and then would have no possible way of altering your set of beliefs. Because you have free will, and this is your universe, this is your reality, you're the only one who's experiencing this, you can choose how you react to any situation. You can choose love or you can choose fear. Either way, it's expansive. It does not matter. But all of you who are here now, whether you're on the call now or listening at a later date, have come forth at this time of awakening to express love. Now, expressing love is not always easy in an environment where fear exists. And so you'll have to consciously say, how am I feeling right now? Am I feeling aligned with love right now? Or am I feeling fear right now? If I'm aligned with love right now, well, then I perceive that everything's going well. I am happy. I'm confident. I'm satisfied in what I'm doing. I'm seeing that everything is working out. And then something comes along to trigger some limiting belief, and you will fall back into the fear, and you will attach yourself to fear-based consciousness for a bit of time. That fear-based consciousness will now line you up with images, thoughts, and urges to control or change the conditions. And so if you spend some time controlling conditions or acting on urges or fighting against what you think is wrong, you'll be exploring the inauthentic, the limited version of you, and you'll expand through those experiences, but not in the way that you intended prior to your birth, in a way that is expansive, but not full of joy. It's not fun. It's not enjoyable. It doesn't add love into your reality. It adds more fear into that reality. You've come now and you say, I want to make a new life. I want to make new choices. I want to see things more clearly. I want to rise above the illusion that's caused by fear and see the reality that this entire system is based in love, including me, including everyone I know, and including my conditions. What appears to me, my house, my town, my city, my yard, my family, my society in general, it's all based in love. The entire planet is based in love. I want to see through the illusion caused by fear, and I want to see the love that actually exists. I want to see the brilliance and perfection in the moment as often as possible. And this is available to all of you. All you have to do is make a conscious choice. But if you're living life as a victim, if you're trying to protect yourself, if you're saying things should be different than they are in order for you to feel something that you're not feeling right now, if you perceive yourself to be lacking anything, well, you're participating in the illusion. That is not true. Now, there's some safety and comfort in that perception of reality. It's what you're used to. It allows you to sort of think you have some control over it, even though that control is not true. In the letting go of all that, in the going with the flow of everything you're experiencing, in raising your perception of reality and your vibration, you can see through all that. You can realize when you're out of alignment and linked into fear-based consciousness and receiving thoughts to change the conditions, or when you're in alignment, when you're receiving inspiration, and when you are looking at reality as it really is. You're looking at the love side of the reality. If you can look at the love side of your reality, if you can say, I am a being of love. Everyone else in my reality is a being of love. The entire system of physical reality is based in love. The hurricanes are love. The forest fires are love. The earthquakes are love. The viruses are love. Everything is based in love. Everything is helping all humanity to move forward, to see through the illusion and to the reality. Most humans are not ready for this, and that's fine. Most humans are still living in fear, and that's part of what they came here to explore. Yet you are not most humans. You are intrepid explorers. You are brave souls. You are coming to explore something brand new, and you are paving the way for others to follow. You must hold yourself in that regard and realize that as a advanced being of love who's come here to explore reality in a brand new way, to pave new paths that others will follow, not because you're telling them that they're wrong or hoping that they do better or wishing something different for them, but you are holding yourself in alignment as a being of love and seeing reality in a new way. When you focus on your reality as it's based in love rather than fear, you will create powerful pathways, both physically and non-physically, both consciously and unconsciously, to the fabric of all that is, including the mass consciousness of the world, and others will be able to connect to those new ideas. And that's why we are here, to help you move along your journey of love, adding more love into your reality in the way you intended prior to your birth. You've asked us to be here, and we could not be more thrilled than we are today. And with that, we'd like to talk to you about anything you'd like to talk about. Who would like to start?